सिद्दीकी, फैकल्टीज, IEEE एग्जीक्यूटिव कमेटी मेंबर्स, चेयर शीतान सिंह, वाइस चेयर मौर नंदन त्रिपाठी, ट्रेजर साक्षी प्रेम, सेक्रेटरी अंशिका राय एंड वेब मास्टर शिवाली प्रसाद एंड डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम वेलकमिंग यू ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, बाबू बनारसी दास इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट लखनऊ, एज वेल एज IEEE स्टूडेंट ब्रांच काउंसलर BVD ITM लखनऊ। माई सिंसियर थैंक्स टू डायरेक्टर BVD ITM डॉक्टर भावेश कुमार चौहान एंड फॉर हिज गाइडेंस एंड मोटिवेशन। इट इज माई ग्रेट प्लेजर एंड ऑनर टू वेलकम यू ऑल दिस प्रोग्राम माई स्टोरी मोटिवेशनल सेशन बाई सक्सेसफुल इनोवेटर। अगेन स्पेशली आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सटेंड वार्म वेलकम टू आवर इमिनियंट स्पीकर डॉक्टर यश चटर्जी, एक्सेप्टिंग आवर इन्विटेशन ग्रेटली फॉर मेकिंग दिस इवेंट सक्सेसफुल। वी आर इंडीड ग्रेटफुल फॉर योर ग्रेसियस प्रेजेंस। आई एम सो हैप्पी टू सी यू टूगेदर हेयर। आई होप द प्रोग्राम विल बी ग्रेट सक्सेसफुल। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस। ओवर टू द एंकर। थैंक यू।
Thank you so much, sir, for your blessed words. Professor S. Chatterjee has been awarded PhD degree in Electrical Engineering from Punjab University, Chandigarh. He has obtained BE in Electrical Engineering and MACT Bhopal. Professor Chatterjee has obtained ME in Electrical Engineering from MNNIT Allahabad. He is a member of IEEE, Life Member ISTE, Fellow IEN, also Life Member NITTR, Alumni Association. He is super annuated from NITTR Chandigarh as professor and head electrical engineering department. He has a total experience of about 45 years, 43 years in academics and 2 years in industry. Professor Chatterjee has supervised 16 PhD theses and 115 ME theses. He has written 2 textbooks in electrical engineering and has more than 200 publications in various international and national journals. To his credit, he has won the best paper award in IE journal. Now, it's my humble and sincere request to our eminent speaker, Dr. S. Chatterjee, to start the expert lecture. The stage is all yours, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. At the outset, I would like to thank the organizers, Dr. Rafiq, Dr. Muhyiddin Khadim, who's happened to be very close to me. And he has earlier worked with me at an institute in Hoshiarpur. So I am very much thankful to the organizers to give me an opportunity to be amongst you for sharing my experience in leadership qualities. So can you see my PPTs, please? Now I'll put them.
No, sir.
I'll put them.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay, thank you. So leadership, the word is very encouraging, very attracting, and it's a very heavy word also. Very heavy word. Who's a leader and what should be the qualities? Can A, B, C, D be a leader? What is the difference between a leader and a boss? What is leadership? What is bossship? And what are the qualities what make a leader great? There can be many leaders, but are they all great? So these are some of the content which I'm going to share with you. The contents are here before you. What is leadership? What is leadership process? Manager versus leader. I like to compare a manager versus a leader. boss versus leader. Again, a manager is different, a boss is different, a leader is different altogether. Leadership responsibilities. What are the responsibilities of a leader? What makes leadership a real meaning of leadership? The traits of a leader, traits of a manager, leadership qualities. What is a great leader? How do you make a great leader? What is a community leader? And what is the difference between the winner versus leaders? Are every winner a leader or every leader a winner? So these are some of the contents which I'm going to discuss in this session. So now to start with, what is leadership? As per the Wikipedia, the definition is given like this. Leadership is both a research area and a practical skill encompassing the ability of an individual or organization to lead or guide other individuals, teams, or the entire organization. Now, look at the words. Please focus and concentrate on the words. It is not the individual. It could be an individual. Guide an individual. He's a leader. He's a supervisor. He can guide or supervise a team, which is more than one. And it can also guide or supervise an entire organization. So it's a very big canvas which a leader takes and compares. So this is what is the definition of Wikipedia. According to Wikipedia, this is leadership. Now, the action of leading a group of people or an organization. What are the actions? What are the tasks? It is the guidance. It is the authority. It is the direction. It is the control. And altogether, it is the management also. So you have to guide. That means you have to supervise. You have to tell everything that this is to be done. How is it to be done? Where should it be done? Why should it be done? And which way it should be done? So this is altogether guidance. A PhD thesis guide is many times called a supervisor. So that is guidance. He has to tell the way, the approach. In engineering language, we call it the algorithm. That is to be told to the students. So he becomes a guide in that PhD or an ME or any graduation course. But altogether, guidance means it is the path making. You have to lay down the path. You have to lead that this is the direction here you have to go. The authority, you have to build in the authority in the team, in the individual, in the organization also. You have to provide the direction. Unless you provide the direction, the whole organization may be misleading. So direction is also very important. Control. Anything which is under control will be smooth, will give you the right kind of output, will give you the right kind of product, what you want. And if it is not controlled, it goes out of your hands and you are with no, that the result is nothing and it will be a sorry figure. So control is also very important. And finally, the management, all the activities concerned in an organization, in a work, in a planning, everything is to be managed. So these are the five main functions what a leader has to lead, in a way, guide or lead. The state or position of being a leader. One is the direction, the other is the governance. In short, we can say that direction and governance are the two main objectives or the aim or the motto of a guide. Now, leadership is the art of motivating a group of people to act toward achieving a common goal. This is very important. The goal has to be a common one. When there is a football match, then the two teams are playing each other. They are rivals. And this team, suppose there are two teams, A and B. A tries to get the ball in the goal post of the B team. And vice versa, B also wants to do the same thing in the goal of A. So the common goal for 11 people who are representing the team A or team B, they have a common goal. Now the ball is to be put in that goal. So that is the final aim or the goal. And leadership is the art of motivating all the people concerned here, a group, and to act forward towards achieving this particular goal. In business setting, this can mean directing workers, colleagues, with a strategy to meet the needs of the company or the organization. Now, this strategy or the process or the algorithm or the methodology is to be set by the leader, and how he sets it, he or she sets it, puts it in front of the group of the people again to achieve the goal. And that strategy is very, very important. That comes out of the leadership quality of that person who's leading it. Maybe a manager, maybe a boss, anything, maybe a supervisor, depends on the size and type of the task you are doing. So this is one example I have taken. The leader is in front with that speaker in his hand, and he talks anything, he gives the direction, and the people are following it. In the second part, we are saying the people, all the people from bottom to top, they are following this leader and further going down also. So the leader has to put the words in such a way, he has to put the direction in such a way that everybody gets involved in it, and for a common goal, for a common task, they follow his orders, his message, and his methodology to achieve the goal, which is the common goal for the whole organization. Leadership is a process. It is another definition. It is a process of social influence, which maximizes the efforts of others towards the achievement of a common goal. Again and again, I'm using this word common goal. This is very important. The goal has to be common. If you have different goals, then the leader will not be, howsoever efficient and good and effective he may be, will never be able to achieve that. So the goal should be common. And then it is the quality of the leader who leads the team, who leads the organization to achieve that particular common goal. Leadership stems from social influence, not authority or power. It is basically from the social influence. It is not from the authority. It is not taken. It is inbuilt. And that comes from the social influence or power. It requires others, and that implies they don't need to be direct reporters. A leader does not have essentially to be a direct reporter, but he is a reporter. He is a leader in his own sense, in his own influence, in his own ability, in his own capabilities. And all those things put together is named as leadership qualities. Manager versus leader. As I said, I would like to compare a manager. Who's a manager and who's a leader? What is the basic difference between the two? A leader even invents or innovates, while a manager organizes the activities. Leader of team comes up with new ideas. Now, here is the catch. You have to understand that who is a leader and who's a manager. The leader invents or innovates. It may sometimes discover its own way of doing things. So this is the innovation is there, the invention is there, the discovery is there. While a manager simply organizes the given activities. If the activities are defined, they are set, then to organize that becomes much easier a task, and that is the job of a manager. So a manager need not to be a leader. So leader has to be a manager also, because he also has to organize things. But he, other than organizing, he or she has to invent, innovate, and also sometimes discover different methodologies, different ways, different approaches to achieve an optimum solution. Leader of the team comes up with new ideas. This is very, very important. Sometimes the manager also works as a leader. If he's an efficient manager, if he's a good manager, if he's an effective manager, so he may also come out with good ideas. So that is a leadership quality. So it is not always said that the manager cannot be a leader. Manager can always be a leader if he has certain properties, certain जिसको हिंदी में गुण कहते हैं, वो अगर उनके बीच में है तो वो भी एक आइडियल लीडर बन सकता है. मैनेजर रिलाइज ऑन कंट्रोल, वेयर एज अ लीडर इंस्पायर्स ट्रस्ट. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. मैनेजर जो है वो एक कंट्रोल के ऊपर विश्वास करता है, जबकि लीडर जो है वो ट्रस्ट, विश्वास के ऊपर जीता है और वो लोगों को इंस्पायर करता है ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ट्रस्ट. A leader is that person who pushes employees to do their best by motivating them. The motivation is one thing which comes from a leader. If it comes from a manager, I would like to call that manager a leader also. So motivating is aisi ek gun hai, motivating aisa factor hai jo ki inbuilt flow karta hai leader se. वो ऐसे मोटिवेट करता है टीम को या एम्प्लॉयज को या ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल को कि वो बाध्य हो जाते हैं उस काम को उस तरीके से करने के लिए जो वो चाहता है या वो जो जिस चीज को कहता है. सो दैट इज यू कैन से दैट देयर लाइज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ मैनेजर एंड लीडर. एंड आई ऑलवेज से दैट ए गुड मैनेजर कैन बिकम अ लीडर ऑल्सो इफ ही इंबाइब सम ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज एज वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑफ अ लीडर. सो द मैनेजर टर्न्स आउट टू बी अ गुड लीडर ऑल्सो. A leader asks the questions what and why, where also. On the other hand, a manager tries to learn more towards how and when. Now, look at the difference. What, why, where. These are the questions which a leader normally asks. Iski kya zarurat hai? Kaha zarurat hai iski? Kyun zarurat hai? Whereas, manager jo hai, wo isko kaise karna hai aur kab karna hai? इसी को लेके ज्यादातर सोचता है. He puts his energy in thinking about how and when. So this is the basic difference of a manager and a leader. And manager is a member of an organization, carry out the different five functions. So functions जो है वो किसी organization के set होते हैं, defined होते हैं. उनको करने के लिए जो उसकी responsibility है उसको manager निभाता है. Whereas leader के केस में ऐसा नहीं है. लीडर के केस में क्या है कि उसके पास बहुत सारे आइडियाज होते हैं. वो कई चीजें नई भी ला सकता है जो शायद ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में नहीं है, जो शायद कंपनी के पास नहीं है. कंपनी कई बार उन आइडियाज को मान भी लेती है. समटाइम्स द कंपनी डजंट एग्री ऑल्सो. नाउ द लीडर हैज द गुड लीडर हैज द कैपेबिलिटी टू कन्विंस द मैनेजमेंट, to convince the company company people, high-ended people, that these are the things if you can implement, aapko fayda hone wala hai. So that is a leadership quality. Manager kya hota hai, wo bandha hua hota hai. Certain rules, regulation unhi ko follow karta hai, kuch functions ko implement karne ke liye kaam karta hai. Lekin leader jo hai, other than functions, other than those rules and regulations, wo bahar ke out of बॉक्स थिंक करता है. और अगर उसके पास आइडियाज है, इफ इज अ गुड लीडर देन ही इज बबलिंग विद आइडियाज, ही इज फुल ऑफ आइडियाज, द न्यू आइडियाज, द नोवेल आइडियाज, और वो उनको लाने की कोशिश करता है. नाउ दिस डायग्राम ऑल्सो सेज लिटिल बिट ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द मैनेजमेंट एंड द लीडरशिप. द मैनेजमेंट हैज द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स, दैट इज प्लानिंग, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग, स्टाफिंग, कोऑर्डिनेटिंग एंड कंट्रोलिंग. Whereas on the other hand, leadership has influencing, motivating, inspiring, creating and mentoring. Now look at the difference. Management जो बंदा है, जो manager है, जो management का बंदा है या manager है, वो क्या करता है? वो plan जरूर करता है. वो उन चीजों को, जो activities है, जो task है, उन सबों को organize करता है in many ways, CPM, PERTs, etc. You may be all knowing. So वो जो है वो management tools है. उन मैनेजमेंट टूल्स को यूज करता है, प्लान करता है और अकॉर्डिंगली ही प्लान्स द स्टाफ, मैन पावर, स्टाफिंग. और उन जब लोगों को मिल जाता है, सबको काम बांट देता है, डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर देता है, उनको कोऑर्डिनेट करता है और उनको कंट्रोल करता है विद इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रूल्स. लेकिन लीडरशिप जो है वो थोड़ा हटके है. इट इज डिफरेंट देन मैनेजमेंट. ये क्या करता है? लोगों को इन्फ्लुएंस करता है. नाउ देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन इन्फ्लुएंसिंग पीपल एंड आस्किंग पीपल टू डू अ जॉब इन अ पर्टिकुलर फैशन. इन्फ्लुएंसिंग इज समथिंग एल्स. इन्फ्लुएंसिंग इज अ क्वालिटी व्हिच a person imbibes, and if he or she can take this quality to others also, agar kar sakta influence, then he is a good leader. Motivating. He has to be a motivator. A manager can be a motivator. If he is a good manager, he can be a good motivator. But a leader is basically a motivator. He will give examples, he will put some success stories before the people, and they will be motivated by seeing those, by listening to those. So that is the leadership quality. Inspire karta hai logon ko. He or she always inspire people to do something, to achieve something. Aur wo inspire karne ke liye motivate karna zaruri hai, unko success stories dena zaruri hai, unko nayi ideas batana zaruri hai, aur finally influence karna zaruri hai, so that they follow that path. He can create things. Leadership quality mein ek bahut badi cheez hoti hai, that creating new things, that is innovating things, sometimes discovery, sometimes invention. Many people, the inventors, they are actually leaders. So create karna is a leadership quality. And mentoring, controlling and mentoring are two different things. Controlling is something which can be done with a stick also, carrot and stick, or some other way of doing it, good, bad, merit, demerit, etc., etc. But mentoring is something which comes out of a leader. वो उसकी एक क्वालिटी अलग होती है जो वो किसी किसी बंदे को मेंटर कर सकता है. एंड व्हाट हैपेंस, मैनेजर, इफ अ वेरी गुड मैनेजर, अ ब्रिलियंट मैनेजर इज देयर, देन ही मे आल्सो बिकम अ गुड मेंटर. मेंटर इज हूज टेकन एज अ रोल मॉडल. सपोज कोई आपका रोल मॉडल बनता है, वो क्यों बनता है? आप उसको ट्राई करते हैं फॉलो करने के लिए हर चीज में. वो कैसे ड्रेसअप करता है, वो बात कैसे करता है, हाउ ही मूव्स, how he solves problems, how he takes the opportunities, how he react to things. Agar in sab cheezon ko aap follow karte hai, you will say that he is my role model. So mentoring is very, very different than controlling, and it's a very hard task also. And I would again say, if a manager, there is no bar, a manager can definitely become a good leader if he imbibes other than his technical skills, these qualities, these soft skills also, so he can become a good leader. A manager can turn out to be a good leader, an effective leader also, and it is 100% sure that his success will follow. But there are certain common aspects also. For example, a manager and a leader, both they use these, that is communicating, problem solving, and decision making. A manager has to take decisions at opportunities, at situations given. A leader also has to take decisions. Problem solving is a common area where both the manager as well as the leader works. They work. And communicating is definitely the first tool. A manager has to be a good communicator. A leader has to be a good communicator. If you are not a good communicator, you neither can become a manager nor can become a leader. Now again, this slide shows a comparison between leadership versus management. Leadership is there who moves with the flag. He's a flag bearer, and people follow. They follow the person through the flag. As the person is moving, the track he's taking, all are moving in the same track. Whereas a manager is through some education, through some slides, through some ways, through some other supplements, he tells you that this is happening here, this is happening here, you can do it like this, you can do it like this. So this is the management techniques, and this is the leadership technique. A leadership is a general person who will take the mob, who will take the mass with him or her, and he or she is basically a flag bearer. Now again, you can see this slide. The leader is in the front, whereas the manager is at the back. I'm not again criticizing a manager. The manager is at the back of a task. The whole task is being done by the team, and the manager from the back provides you the opportunity. He provides you the methodology. He provides you all sorts of required requirements, but he does not lead from the front. He is at the back. So leader with this red, this thing, at the upper figure, you can see that he is leading. He is also taking part in the work. And unless he does this from the front, if he doesn't lead, he is not a leader. I would like to give the example of the cricket team. A cricket team captain is a leader. He may not be, he is called a leader, he is not called a manager. So unless he performs himself, unless he performs the way one should perform, he will not turn out to be a good captain. So he has to perform with the bat, with the ball, with the fielding, etc., with the keeping, everything. So then he becomes a leader, and then everyone follows him. He becomes the role model. And then only the other team members will try to do their best. So this is a leader who takes the best out of every individual. Whereas the manager puts every potential in the whole team and the team works for him. So management, planning, organizing, leading and control. Managers also tend to be a leader, but only if they adequately carry out their leadership responsibilities. This is leadership qualities as well as leadership responsibilities. If we don't have the leadership qualities and you don't carry out the leadership responsibilities, you can never become a leader and you can never become a good manager also. On the other hand, if a manager with his experience, with his qualities, with his qualifications, with his nature, if he can imbibe the qualities of a leader and he carries out the leadership responsibilities, he turns out to be a best manager. Okay. Now it is the question between a boss and a leader. Now, who's a boss, who's a manager? Boss is a hard taskmaster. Boss is always correct. This is the belief. You believe that boss cannot be wrong. Boss is not good. Boss is khadoos type ka boss hai. Ye bahut sare log kehte hain. Then boss, why it is so? The people are afraid of a boss. The people are not afraid of a leader. People can always have they can always access a leader, but they can not always access a boss. Boss ka ek hawa hota hai, ek dar hota hai, ek fear hota hai. माइंड में एक फियर होता है कि बॉस शायद मुझे आज नौकरी से निकाल देगा. आजकल के जमाने में लोग कहते हैं बॉस विल फायर मी. ये फायर मी का कॉन्सेप्ट चला हुआ है. हु फायर्स यू, द लीडर और द बॉस? सो बॉस हैज दैट काइंड ऑफ अ नेचर, ही हैज दैट काइंड ऑफ अ व्हाट शुड आई से कैरेक्टर. ही ड्राइव एम्प्लॉइज, डिपेंड्स ऑन अथॉरिटी, इंस्पायर्स फियर, सेज आई, प्लेसेस ब्लेम ऑन द ब्रेकडाउन. He always says it is I who get the work done. Depends on the authority, all right, but he inspires fear. He will create a fear. He will create a frustration also. The fear will further create frustration in you. And people are afraid of a boss. They are feared, boss fearing. And but they say, yes, boss. Boss is always yes. Boss is always correct. He uses people. He has that kind of a controlling power in him. And many people, many managers, when they become the top boss, they imbibe certain responsibilities, certain kind of properties, and manufacture themselves in a way that they become a very tidy boss. And people take pride out of it, that I'm a very big boss and I am a boss and these people are my under, they're working under me. So they take pride out of it, takes credit. He always has the nature of taking the whole credit, and the discredit should go to the workers, the people working under him. He uses people. He has the tendency that you have to do it for me. I do not know whether you have time or not, either you have time to do your own work or not, whether you are thorough with your files or not, but this work, which is my personal work or my work, official work, this is to be done today by now. So that kind of a nature is a boss. He commands, says go. He always says go, get this thing done, to report to me, come at this time. These are the statements normally used by bosses. He drives employees, it depends on authority, he inspires fears, places blame, for the breakdown. If anything goes wrong, he will say it is your responsibility, don't take. You, if you go to him that, sir, this is the problem, don't come to me with the problem, come with the solution also, then I'll decide. So he has that kind of a tendency, he has that kind of a nature, which is, with time and again, he has become like that. He has rather manufactured himself like that. So takes the credit and uses people, and the discredit should go to the people working under him. And he always says, go, do it for me, a report, that kind of sentence. Whereas on the other side, the leader, he coaches them. He tells them, one, goodwill. Always try to have a goodwill. And the boss may be good, but he will never get a goodwill. Hardly any bosses are there who create goodwill among the workers working with him. Generate enthusiasm. He'll always try to motivate. The motivation is there, that inspiration is there. So you get enthusiastic about doing a work. Says, yes, we. He will not say, I. The boss here, he might says, I. Here, the people, the leader will always say, we. We do it. We can do it. We can achieve it. He will never say, I. Fixes the breakdown. He doesn't like breakdowns, but he will never say that a breakdown responsibility is yours. He will fix it up and always try to give a solution to it with discussions. We'll like to discuss with people and always generate a good optimum solution. How is it done? He will try to show it. This is his nature. This is his tendency. This is his the knowledge, and with time and again he has developed and imbibed these properties. He develops people, gives credit to all. Now, when you give credit, discredit you give, but you also should give the credits. It is not that the credit is mine, the discredit is yours. So, like that, what he does with time, he will develop people. That is what is HRD, human resource development. Human resource is there. You have human resource with leader, you have human resource with boss also. But who is the developer? HRD. HRD factor is missing perhaps in the boss's case, and it is always there for a leader. So he develops people. He tries them how to develop. He gives them methodology. He tells them, he motivates them, he inspires them. Asks, says, let us go. He will never say go. He says, let's go. Let's all together try this. Let's all together do this. If it is success, it is all our success. If it does not success, failure, then it is our failure. So that is the basic difference between a boss and a leader. In the leadership versus management. Now there is a lot of debates have taken place. Now I will try to give you little points, little about the management and the leadership. The management promotes stability, order, and problem solving within existing organizational structure and systems. Whereas the leadership promotes vision, creativity, and changes. The change is always good. The change is always welcome. But how to get it? Which way change? Why change? These are the questions a leader asks and a leader tries to build up among the team members. Whereas management, it promotes stability, order, and problem solving within existing organizational structure and system. He will not go out of rules and regulations. Many times the leaders, they try a lot of, they take a lot of risk beyond their capacity. If he thinks it is for the well-being, if it is good for the structure, he will jolly well take that risk. Takes care of where you are. Only care where you are, and the leader takes care to a new place. Whenever there is a change in environment, change in your workplace, change in your work time, change in your occupation, it is the leader who motivates you. He will take care. And the manager, management, actually, the rules of management is, it is confined to the present situation. It takes care of where you are. So this is the M versus L comparison. Leadership responsibilities. Now, I was talking to you that leader has to have certain qualities, but then it definitely bears certain responsibilities. What are the responsibilities? The communication, the motivation, the inspiration, guidance and encouragement. But all of them are for employees to rise to the higher level of productivity. It is good for the organization. It is good for the company. It is good for the individual. It is good for the mass. And how to get that achieved, that communication is to be there. The leader has to communicate it properly so that every individual understands what is that, how it should be done, what is the algorithm, what is the methodology. He or she should be motivational. Every individual should be motivated to the level that, yes, this is the correct approach. This is the function we have to carry out. And how is this to be carried out? They are 100% sure and motivated to do that. And for that, inspiration has to be there. If the leader is unable to inspire you, he will not be able to motivate you. So inspiration and motivation, they go together. First, he has to motivate and then inspire. Motivate means, I think this is correct. You believe me that this is correct and this is to be done like this. Now inspire you, give you some success story, tell you some capabilities, tell you some happenings regarding this, tell you some history so that he is inspired and motivated to do that. And then guide, then tell them, yes, go away this way, don't go this way, try to do this algorithm, try to take this approach, which is guidance, which is many people do, and it is actually the supervision. And then encouragement is very, very important. If you cannot encourage, if you always discourage a person, he will never achieve his goal. You have to be an encourager. Basic thing is encouragement. Yes, it is not no. It is yes, you can do it. Success, not failure. And finally, it is all done for employees to rise to the higher level of productivity. So leadership traits and skills, you can have this. Traits and skills, it is tabulated here. Traits are adaptable to situations, alert to social environment, ambitious, achievement-oriented, assertive, cooperative, decisive, dependable, dominant, desire to influence others. Unless you are not, many times if you are only sweet talker and you only are goody-goody, you cannot become a leader. You have to be sometimes depend, also dominant. Then energetic, you have to be full with positive energy, not negative energy, fully positive. You should be a positive thinker. Unless you are a positive thinker, you cannot become a positive energetic person. Persistent and consistency in action. You have to persuade things. Persistent and consistency is very, very important in every action of a leader. Self-confident and integrity. If you're not an honest person, you can never turn out to be a good leader. You have to be the honest person. The integrity is basic principle and property of a good leader. And self-confident. If you are not confident in yourself, how can you lead others? How can you tell others to do that? You show it by doing yourself. When you do it, then only others will say, yes, this is possible. And you, for doing it, you have to be confident. If you're not self-confident, I don't think anything can make you do the things in a positive manner. Tolerant and stress, tolerant of stress. You have to be very much tolerant. You have to listen to the people. You should be a good listener also. Not only a good talker, but a good listener. Unless you have the tolerance, you will not be able to listen to others. You should have that property of tolerance of stress. So must listen to others. Willing to assume responsibility. You should be a responsible person. You must be willing to assume responsibility. If you don't take any responsibility, you can never turn out to be a leader. And what are the skills? They are tabulated here. Clever and intelligent. Now, clever is a word which is very, very debatable word. I would say intelligent. Intelligent person can be a good, this is a good skill to be a good leader. You have to be intelligent, you have to understand the situation, you have to work as per the situation. How is it complex? Is it viable? All these things you have to understand. An intelligent person can only understand. Then conceptually skilled, you have to understand the concept. How is it coming? From where it is coming? Why should it be done? How should it be done? What should be the optimum method of doing it? So that is all creativity. You have 80%, then only you can be a good leader. Diplomatic and tactful, very important. At times we have to be diplomatic. You cannot always say, yes, I mean this only, and this should happen, and this should happen in this way only. That is not possible. People are not going to listen to you. You have to tactfully manage the situation. And many times, at times, you have to be a diplomat. You play diplomacy also. Fluent in speaking, of course, is a communication skill. You have to impart your idea by speaking. A leader, good leader, is he or she who can know many languages. If he can speak only one language, I don't think he'll have the fluency and speaking to people. He should have that. And many times people go to villages and suburban areas wherein they have to know the local language. So fluency in speaking should be there. Unless they speak that language, he'll not be able to impress the people and imply whatever he says. Knowledgeable about the group task. Whatever task he's asking for the group to do, he should first of all master that. He should be knowing that task very well, and he should understand it, and he should read the viability, whether it is possible to do it. If it is not possible to do a task and you are asking the person to do it, it will never work. So knowledgeable, and to do the task, you must understand its viability, whether it is possible or not. Organized administrative ability. This is an administrative ability. You should be able to organize the things. You should read the people that whose capability is what. And you many times that between A, B, C, D, four persons, A could be very, very skillful, and B could be theoretically well, C could be good in some other thing. So now you have to be an administrator, and you impart the duties in such a fashion, the A gets the best kind of thing, what he likes to do, B gets the thing, what he likes to do, and similarly C and D. And that is known as administrative ability. So you should be a good administrator also. An good administrator can be a leader also. Persuasive and socially skilled. Socially skilled, I've already explained, that should be able to behave with the local people. You should understand their difficulties. You should understand you should be merciful. And you should understand by going to them, by meeting them, by being a member there of their family, then you should be persuasive, and then you can understand what is the real problem. Once you understand the real problem, you will be able to generate the correct solution for that particular problem. Unfortunately, all the managers are not leaders. This is a very, very important statement. A leader does not necessarily hold or occupy a management position, or in other words, I mean, let it be clear that the leader may not have a very important post from the management, but the general manager, he has a post, a works manager, he has a post, he represents the company through that. So he represents the company, but a leader does not necessarily hold and occupy a management position. How is it, in other words, what does it say? A leader does not have to be an authority figure in the organization. Try to understand this. A leader, if he is, then it is well and good, but it is not necessary. So does not have to be an authority figure in the organization. A leader can be anyone. For example, a union leader. A union is simply a worker. He does not hold a very key post in the management. He does not represent the company like this manager, the material manager, the general manager, the works manager, or a very big supervisor, or a chief engineer, or something like that. But he is simply a worker. He works in a small area, in a small section of that factory, but he has certain qualities, and he can become a union leader. So he has imbibed those properties, those qualities, those disciplines, those responsibilities by which he turns out to be a union leader. So this is in nutshell that managers, not all the managers are not leader. All the managers are not leaders. A leader does not necessarily hold it, occupy a management position, and he can be just a simple worker, a simple authority in the organization, but he can always turn out to be a good leader. the traits of a manager. Number one is ability to execute vision. Managers build a strategic vision and break it into a proper roadmap for their team to follow. This is very important. This is manager's first build responsibility and duty, I suppose, that he builds a strategic vision and breaks it into a proper roadmap for their team to follow. And once he is able to make every team member to understand that, it becomes easy for all the team members to follow it. And naturally, that becomes effective. Second is ability to direct. A manager has to be a director. Managers are responsible for day-to-day efforts while reviewing necessary measures and anticipating needs to make changes along the people procedural steps. And third is the process management. He has to know the process very well. As I said, within the organization's structure, within the rules and regulations, then he becomes a good manager. So the managers have the authority to establish the work rules, process, standards, and operating procedures. They have these properties. They should be very well equipped with all these so that they manage the things well. So these are basically the traits. There's certain more. I think, yes, people focused. They should be people focused also. Managers are known to look after and cater to the needs of the people. Well, if you are a HR manager, human resource manager, then it is very, very important. You should be people focused. Unless you understand what are the requirements of your people working under you, what are the things they need, what are the difficulties they face, what are the good things they feel like. If you don't know all these things, you can never become a good manager. And you have to basically know all these things to be specifically for a HR manager, human resource manager. They are responsible for listening to them, involving them in certain key decisions, and accommodating reasonable requests for change to contribute to increased productivity. Now, again, the manager, be it a manager, be it a leader, be it anyone, the top executive, the CEO, whosoever it is, their common objective is to increase the productivity so that everyone gets the facility equally and they get the benefit out of it. So they are responsible for listening to them, involving them in certain key decisions and accommodating reasonable requests for change to contribute to increased productivity. If their thinking is not taken into mind, if what they think that what it should be done, how it should be done, I think this is the better way of doing it. This material can be replaced. But many times the workers have very good ideas. So if you don't involve them, if you don't listen to them, if you only command them and give them orders, I don't think that becomes a good manager. So it is not the trait of a good manager. They are responsible for listening to every individual, involve them for certain key decisions. Many times the workers give such good decisions that if you take those decisions, it has contributed a lot in the productivity. So this is how you are the champions of change, effective problem-solving skills, results-driven, supportive of others, and encourages a variety of perspectives. So this is on the whole a diagram which tells you that in charo cheezo ke means effective problem-solving, results-driven, supportive of others, encourages a variety of perspectives. In some of agar mila diya jaye, to champions of change, champions of all change will take place. So mila ke, in some of ko mila ke, you get the changes and you get the product, you get the result. This is the how you go up. The base is honesty, integrity, trust, trustworthiness, faithfulness, obedience, justice, and mercy. Then next is the vision, commitment, discipline. And get things done. Bottom was be honorable. Then it is engagement, selflessness, respect. One has to be selfless and respectful. Attitude, courage. Attitude, courage, comes in the motivational level and make good decisions is the truth. This is the priority and the problem solving capabilities, and the top is, as you say, is the truth that makes good decision. So bottom is honesty, integrity, trustworthy, faithfulness, obedience, justice, and mercy. This is for being an honorable manager or honorable leader. Get things done is vision, commitment, and discipline. Engagement is selflessness and respect. And motivation is attitude and courage. And finally, what makes good decision is the truth. So entry level is up to this, and mid level is the attitude. And finally, the senior level is from attitude to truth, that is the decision making, final decision making. You always see the decisions are made by the topmost people, and they are the most highest paid persons. But at the bottom, people are doing lot of work, but they are not that much paid. Why people are paid that high? Because they have to take ultimately the decisions they have to make. And the final decision that increases the productivity of the company, and it is good, and it is the truth. Individual traits that enable system thinking: the tolerance or ambiguity, curiosity, openness, strong interpersonal skills, strong communication skills, ask the right questions. It's very, very important. Curiosity is to know things, know novel things and apply them. Openness, you have to be very much open to know the new things. Unless you are open, you will never become curious to know things. Then strong interpersonal skills has to be very, very strong. That makes a good manager, that makes a good leader. Strong communication skill, you have to be very good at communication. Ask the right questions. If you are curious, you are open, you want to know things, but you are not asking right questions, you will never come to know the solutions. Then navigate complexity. The complexity is there in every step, in every task, in every moment, but one should be able to navigate that. So that is the trait, individual trait actually. Analytical ability. You have to be able to analyze things. And that is a capability, highest capability. You have to analyze and you have to generate the right kind of solution, the optimum solution, and tolerance for ambiguity. If you don't have the tolerance, ambiguity has to be there. Nothing is perfect. No system is perfect. There has to be ambiguity, and you have to be at the tolerance. You have to have the tolerance limit. Then only you can solve problems, and then only you can become a good manager, a good boss, and a good leader, finally. The traits of a leader, finally. The vision, the honesty and integrity, inspiration, skills, ability to challenge. These are the basic traits of a leader. Now let us see quickly the leaders, the resulting synergy, and the managers. This gives you the do right things, promote idea generation, inspire, pursue and create opportunities, create vision. Here, effectiveness, employee innovation, teamwork, accomplishment, empowerment. Very, very important. You have to anchor, accomplish, and empower people. Then only right things can happen. Do things right. This is manager who gives the synergy. Do things right, provide structure, coordinate, react to situation, and provide cross power sources. So these are some of the traits and activities. The leadership skill found in managers. The managers who with time, lot of time, they develop to be a leader. Communication, honesty, integrity, relationship building, innovation, and awareness. Very, very important things. This also gives the subject that manager and leader. Make up role, stability, change. Decision making makes, facilitates. Approach, plans, detail around constraints, and sets around detail leads direction. Similarly, you have control, appeals, culture, action, risk, rules, directions, values, concerns, focus, and human resource. Very important. Human resource regarding that manager, subordinates, and leader followers. The subordinates are the human who the manager manages, whereas the followers are the people who the leader manage. Leadership versus management. Leader is taking hand, individual are following, and manager is placing them like that, and he is giving the ideas, the skills, the orders, and he manages like this. This is the difference. Leader versus manage. If you lead like that, it illuminates ultimately. And manage means you optimize, tries to optimize and get the result. Manager says go, and leader says let's go. This is John Maxwell who said so. Very important. Leadership qualities, in nutshell, we'll discuss. Integrity, ability to delegate, communication skill, self-awareness, gratitude, learning ability and agility, influence and empathy. These are the basic qualities of a leader. And characteristics of a good leader. Effective leadership is a key element in the success of group, and virtually anyone can learn to be effective leader. Leadership skills are the strengths and abilities individuals demonstrate that help the oversee process, guide initiatives, and steer their employees towards the achievements of the goals. Great leader helps a group of people identify what they want and how to get it, and then influence that group to take coordinated action in achieving desired outcome. A great leader achieves results at a level beyond what others achieve. Great leader. What can be a great leader? The quality of being a great leader is not something bestowed upon you on high. Rather, it is something you do. It is not bestowed. It is what you do. It reflects how you analyze, allocate, and align to raise productivity and save time. Some of the world's great leaders are Swami Vivekananda. I will definitely name him here. Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, Nelson Mandela, Steve Jobs, Mother Teresa, Bill Gates, etc. They all use their leadership talents, diverse as they may be, to make the lives better in some way. Achieving freedom, making advanced technology available to all of us, improving living conditions in low-income communities, creating global foundation that fuels the idea that all lives have equal value. What makes a great leader? Leadership is not thought as some fuzzy, entangled character. You see, this is the word I've used. Leadership is not thought as some fuzzy, entangled character qualities that some people are born with and others are not. We think of leadership as the performance of behaviors. The skill of performing these behaviors can be learned and developed by anybody. Some people do not develop these skills and therefore do not perform leader behaviors with competence. Others develop some skills and become pretty good leaders. Others develop considerable skill and become great leaders. This is the concluding. Community leadership, there's a word called community leadership. Community leaders is a designation often by secondary sources for a person who's perceived to present a community, represent a community. A simple way to understand community leadership is to see it as leadership in, for, and by the community. Community is frequently based in place, and so it's local, although it can also represent a community of common interest, purpose, and practice. So knowing the local language, as I was telling you, knowing the local people, their behavior, their demand, their wants, what is the economic background, what is the socioeconomic background. This is how you develop to be a community leader. Who is more important, a leader or a manager? The managers and leaders both are important. And when you find both qualities in the same person, it is like hitting a professional jackpot. So category-wise leadership qualities, personality, internal and external. Internal personality is a communication skill, analytical, well-informed, good listener, good behavior, and gesture. And external is the physique, look, health, etc. Attributes, analytic, justice, sacrifice, mixing and adjusting in nature, discipline, intelligence, understanding, comprehension, application, synthesis, positive attitude, confessing, sincere, hardworking, fearless, large-hearted and should not be short-tempered. This is very, very important. A leader cannot afford to be a short-tempered person. And power and potential will attract convincing, judgmental, analytical decision-making. Thinking, listening, risk-taking, learning to learn, continuous learner, contributing, team player for a common good cause, capable of doing things of his her own, capable of doing experiments for learning new things, experimental approach, and capable of following systematic and scientific approach for solving problems. So leaders is basically, I would like to say it like this in these words, the leader is basically a person who continues learner, who is a continuous learner and a problem solver, who always tries to lead from the front selflessly for the betterment of the humanity, organization, state or nation by creating examples. In doing so, he or she may go any extent, to go any extent possible by taking large amount of risks if found necessary. So that is the basic nature, that is the basic crux of being a leader. So winner versus leader, I would like to in the end say this, who's a winner, who's a leader? Winners never quit and quitters never win. Winners have great focusing capabilities for a particular task. Leaders are basically small performers while winners are hardworking. Leaders keep the team intact and make sure that every team member gets equal and proportionate amount of workload and leisure. So if you ask me to give an example, I would definitely give you the example of Arjuna and Shri Krishna. Arjun was a winner who always focused in one point, who was a selfless, selfish character who wanted to win always. His aim was to win, whereas Krishna was the leader. He took the mass with him. Dronacharya was a leader who took the mass. He gave everyone the opportunity to learn, but it was the winner was only Arjun. So that is, I think I would like to conclude that a leader cannot always be a winner. He should never think in his own way. He should be a selfless person. And a winner cannot be a leader. An individual is a winner, but a whole group, to move the whole group, to motivate the whole group, to inspire the group, to achieve the goal, final goal, is a leader. So this is what I wanted to discuss with you. The discussion is over. It is now open for all of you to ask me questions. Please.
I'm Shambhavi, second year student from Electrical Engineering, Babu Banarsidas Institute of Technology and Management, Lucknow. Thank you so much, Honorable Sir, for such a motivational lecture. We are gracious for your eminent presence over here today. Now I would like to request to all the participants, if you have any questions, please switch on your microphone or leave a question in the comment box as per your convenience. Or you can also ask the question by the raising the hand icon available in the meeting.
Please.
Are there any questions?
Good afternoon, sir. किसी से कोई काम के लिए बोलता है कि नहीं करो, किसी साथी से, उसके बाद उसके पास जाता है तो वो हमेशा नेगेटिव एनर्जी रिफ्लेक्ट करता है, तो इस तरीके से फिर लीडर उस वहां उस लेवल पर उस शख्स से कैसे काम ले, ये थोड़ा सा बताइए प्लीज।
खादिम साहब, ऐसा ही क्वेश्चन आपका बहुत पर्टिनेंट है। आई वुड लाइक टू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल करेक्ट इट दैट जिस पर्सन, जैसे आदमी का आप जिक्र कर रहे हैं, ही इज नॉट अ लीडर। ही इज नॉट अ लीडर। अगर वो लीडर है तो नेगेटिव एनर्जी कभी भी नहीं देगा। Because as I said, leader has to be a positive person. His approach jo hai life mein hamesha positive hota hai. He is meant to motivate. He is meant to inspire. Aur inspirer jo hota hai, motivator jo hota hai, wo negative energy kabhi nahi de sakta. Isiliye main us aadmi ko leader nahi manta. Wo opportunist hai. If he, dekhiye Hindi mein jo neta jisko kehte hain, main usko leader nahi manta. Netaon mein bhi acha neta, bura neta, बदमाश नेता, उत्तम नेता, all those things are there. तो मैं जिस लीडर की बात कर रहा हूँ, वो selfless आदमी है, वो अपने लिए नहीं सोचता है, group के लिए सोचता है। is not an individual person. He is to motivate the whole group. And what for? किस लिए motivate करेगा? किस लिए inspire करेगा? एक common goal को पाने के लिए. इसीलिए अगर वो कुछ आपको कहता है तो कुछ सोच समझ के ही कहता है, और वो हमेशा आपको उसकी methodology बताएगा, उसके अच्छे तरीके बताएगा, उसको किस तरीके से और improve कर सकते हैं वो बताएगा. He is a supervisor in that way. तो उसको उस सब्जेक्ट का पूरा ज्ञान भी होना चाहिए, और एट द सेम टाइम ही शुड नेवर नेवर गिव द नेगेटिव एनर्जी. तो वो आदमी कभी लीडर, सक्सेसफुल लीडर नहीं.
जी थैंक यू क्वेश्चन. सर मेरा एक और क्वेश्चन है, जैसे अभी हमारे फाइनल ईयर के बच्चे अपना प्रोजेक्ट का प्रेजेंटेशन दे रहे हैं, अब उसमें ये है कि हमारी पूरी कमेटी बैठती है और उसके बाद बच्चों को मतलब बताने की कोशिश करती है कि नहीं भाई आप प्रोजेक्ट में अच्छी तरीके से मतलब काम करो, लेकिन उसमें से काफी लोग करने की कोशिश भी करते हैं. लेकिन सर ऐसे मतलब प्रोजेक्ट में बच्चों को किस किस टाइप से गाइड कर देना चाहिए कि मतलब जो अगर एवरेज बच्चा है, अगर बिलो एवरेज बच्चा है, तो वो भी मतलब उस मतलब इनोवेशन की तरफ उसका ध्यान अट्रैक्ट हो. मतलब आपका इसमें क्या व्यू है कि किस तरीके से बच्चों को और मोटिवेट किया जा सकता है?
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सही क्वेश्चन है आपका. देखिए खादिम साहब, ऐसा है कि मोटिवेट करना आपका ऑब्जेक्टिव है, है उनको बताना बेस्ट पॉसिबल मेथड, ऑप्टिमम सॉल्यूशन बताना आपका ऑब्जेक्टिव है, नो डाउट. लेकिन क्लास हमेशा होमोजेनियस नहीं होता है, क्लास इज अ हेटरोजेनियस क्लास. इसमें मेनली तीन प्रकार के स्टूडेंट्स होते हैं. एक जो होता है वो काफी बैक सीट वाले होते हैं. ज्यादातर जो केस होता है, जो मेजोरिटी है, वो मेजोरिटी जो है वो मिड के ग्रुप में आता है, जिनको वो ना तो बहुत खराब है ना बहुत अच्छे है. और बहुत सारे, बहुत कम ऐसे परसेंटेज के स्टूडेंट्स होते हैं, विद ड्यू रेस्पेक्ट टू द स्टूडेंट्स प्लीज डोंट माइंड कि मैं आपको पर्सनली बोल रहा हूँ, तो वो बहुत कम क्लास है जिनको अधिक समझ में भी आता है, जो समझने की कोशिश भी करते हैं, वो थोड़ा सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड भी होते हैं. नाउ आपको जो क्वेश्चन है, तो आप ज्यादा से ज्यादा करिए जो मिडिल ग्रुप है, जो ज्यादा परसेंट के बॉय हैं. मतलब हो सकता है कि 40-45% आपके उसमें हो, 10% या 15% आपके एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी ग्रुप में हो, और उतने ही 10-15% आपके नीचे हो. तो अगर 10% वाले के लिए जो नीचे ग्रुप है उनके करना पड़ेगा, थोड़ा एक्स्ट्रा क्लासेस करना पड़ेगा, थोड़ा सिंपल प्रोजेक्ट से सिंपल टू कॉम्प्लेक्स कॉन्सेप्ट आपको देना पड़ेगा, तो उसके लिए आप एनर्जी अधिक लगानी पड़ेगी, टाइम अधिक देना पड़ेगा. और जो एक्स्ट्रा इंटेलिजेंट लोग हैं उनके लिए आपको प्रॉब्लम ही थोड़ा ट्रिकी देना पड़ेगा, जो कि उनके उनके लेवल को और हाई करे और ज्यादा गेन कर सके, उनको थोड़ा टफर प्रॉब्लम्स आप दे सकते हैं. और जो मिडिल ग्रुप है, जो मेजॉरिटी है, उसके लिए आप नॉर्मल चलिए, उसके लिए आपको फोकस ज्यादा से ज्यादा होना चाहिए, क्योंकि 50-55% के लिए अगर आपने कर दिया तो यू आर अ बिग अचीवर. इसलिए मेरा कहना यह है कि जो नीचे बैक सीट वाले हैं, जो कम थोड़ा सा अंडरस्टैंड करते हैं या लेस इंटेलिजेंट हैं, या अदरवाइज कह लीजिए सोशियो इकोनॉमिकली थोड़े बैक हैं, उनको थोड़ा अलग से आपको केयर करना पड़ेगा, थोड़ा एक्स्ट्रा टाइम देना पड़ेगा, एक्स्ट्रा क्लासेस आपको करना पड़ेंगे, एक्स्ट्रा प्रैक्टिकल क्लासेस बनाने पड़ेंगे, सिंपल एक्सपेरिमेंट्स टू कॉम्प्लेक्स एक्सपेरिमेंट्स बताने होंगे. हो सकता है आपको उनके साथ थोड़ा बताना पड़े, थोड़ा बैठना पड़े. और जो एक्स्ट्रा इंटेलिजेंट लोग हैं उनके लिए आप क्वेश्चन पेपर ऐसा सेट कीजिए, प्रोजेक्ट्स ऐसा सेट कीजिए, प्रैक्टिकल्स ऐसा सेट कीजिए कि आपका ग्रुप ये वाला काम करेगा. और जो मिडिल ग्रुप है उसके लिए नॉर्मली आप अपनी ज्यादा से ज्यादा एनर्जी डिवोट कीजिए. तो मिडिल ग्रुप जो 55% या 60% से भी ज्यादा है, उसको ज्यादा अगर बेनिफिट कर सकते हैं तो टोटल बेनिफिट क्लास का इससे होगा. दिस इज माई व्यू.
जी थैंक यू सो मच सर. शांभवी.
यस सर. Mr. Saqib, do you have a question? You had raised your hand. Mr. Saqib, please unmute.
Yes, sir. And... Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah. You are audible. Please continue.
Sir, can you please tell us the difference between an encouragement and a motivation?
I could not hear you properly.
Sir, his question, I want to know. His question is, can you please tell the difference between encouragement and motivation?
Okay. आपको पहले करना पड़ता है. Motivate is the first thing. कि पहले सबको ये बताइए बच्चों को कि ये जो आप मैं बता रहा हूं इसको आप करने इच्छुक हैं तो आपको क्या क्या फायदा हो सकता है, किस तरीके से आप मोटिवेट करेंगे उनको पहले इस लाइन में लाने के लिए, उनको पहले ब्रिंग देम टू दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम टू दैट पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन को वो उनको अच्छा लगे, इंटरेस्ट क्रिएट करना जिसको कहते हैं, मोटिवेशन इज क्रिएटिंग इंटरेस्ट। तो सबसे पहले बच्चों उनको इंटरेस्ट क्रिएट करना होता है कि जो मैं ये बता रहा हूं ये आपके लिए फायदेमंद है, ये आपको आगे जाके बहुत हेल्प करेगा, यू विल बी हाईली बेनिफिटेड इफ यू डू इट। तो ये इसके लिए आपको सक्सेस स्टोरी वगैरह देना पड़ता है ताकि वो मोटिवेट हो जाए। जब मोटिवेट हो गया तो कीप ऑन डूइंग दिस बिजनेस जिसको कहते हैं इंस्पायरिंग, इंस्पायर कीजिए उनको तो वो और ज्यादा मोटिवेट होंगे, मीन उनका मोटिवेशन लेवल बढ़ता जाएगा। पहले वो मोटिवेशन लेवल बिल्कुल नीचे था, अब मोटिवेट आपने किया, मोटिवेट करने पे वो जीरो लेवल से ऊपर आ गया, उसके बाद जब आप इंस्पायर करेंगे तो वो उसका लेवल बढ़ता जाएगा। उसके बाद उसको जब टास्क देंगे उस टास्क में वो कैसा भी काम करे उसको एनकरेज करना, मीन्स शाबाशी देना। अगर मान लीजिए कि वो पहले ठीक से नहीं कर पाता है तो उसको दुत्कारिए नहीं, डोंट जस्ट टेल हिम ब्लंटली दैट यू आर फेल, यू आर नथिंग, यू नो नथिंग, आपको कुछ नहीं होगा, आगे जाके आप कुछ नहीं कर पाएंगे। नो, दिस इज नॉट एनकरेजमेंट। एनकरेजमेंट पे बताइए कि बेटा हो सकता है आप इस बार नहीं कर पाएंगे, कर पाए हैं अगले बारे में आप अच्छा करेंगे, अगर उस बार भी नहीं होता देन अगले बारे में करेंगे, अगर नहीं कर पाएंगे तो सिंपल टास्क देके उनको दीजिए। वो जब ऐसे लेवल में आ जाएगा कि हाँ मैं इस काम को करना चाहता हूँ और मैं अब इसको करने में थोड़ा मजा आ रहा है, दैट इज एनकरेजमेंट। जब वो थोड़ा उस लेवल में आ जाएगा उसको फर्दर आप बढ़ाते जाइए, दैट इज एनकरेजमेंट। सो मोटिवेशन कम्स फर्स्ट, देन कम्स इंस्पिरेशन बाय टेलिंग देम द सक्सेस स्टोरीज, एंड फाइनली एनकरेज देम मींस उनको इनपुट और दीजिए, शाबाशी दीजिए, उनको दुत्कारिए नहीं। दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मोटिवेशन एंड एनकरेजमेंट।
थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू।
Anybody else has any question?
Yes, sir. Sir, can you ask a question?
Yes.
Sir, मेरा नाम नसीमुल्ला है। सर, मेरा question ये है कि जैसे कि अभी फोर्थ ईयर में हम लोग हैं तो वो क्या बेसिक चीजें होंगी जो हम सारे लोग को जितने भी बच्चे हैं सीखना चाहिए टू बिकम अ गुड लीडर। और दूसरा क्वेश्चन ये है कि हाउ टू बी ए मल्टी टास्कर, क्योंकि नॉर्मली हम लोग एक काम मिलता है जहां दूसरा आया सब उलझ गया, ये भी खराब हो गया वो भी खराब हो गया, तो कैसे सारी चीजों को मैनेज करके दोनों में बेहतर कर सके।
ऐसा है, क्या नाम बताया आपने?
नसरुल्ला।
अच्छा नसरुल्ला साहब, ऐसा है कि बहुत बढ़िया क्वेश्चन आपने पूछा है कि मल्टी टास्कर कैसे बनना है और किस तरीके से कौन सी चीजें सीखनी है जिससे कि आप सक्सेस पा सके, बेसिकली ये आपका क्वेश्चन है। देखिये मल्टी टास्कर बनने के लिए आप जो जो पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं उसमें आप देखिए कि क्या क्या चीजें हैं जो आप खुद से कर सकते हैं या जिनको बिना किया आपकी गाड़ी आगे नहीं। एग्जाम्पल देता हूं कि अगर आप मोटरसाइकिल चलाना सीखना चाहते हैं या आप कार ड्राइव करना चाहते हैं तो उससे आपको सिर्फ कार का शेप, कार का नाम, कौन सा इंजन है, कौन वो पेट्रोल है या डीजल है, ये जानने से नहीं चलेगा। उसको चलाने के लिए उसकी जो ऑपरेटिंग जो चीजें हैं, आपका वो कहाँ एक्सेलेरेटर कहाँ है और आपका क्लच कहाँ है, एबीसी बोलते हैं ना, आपकी ड्राइविंग व्हील कहाँ है, कितने एंगल्स कितने स्पीड से आपको जाना चाहिए, कब ब्रेक लगाना चाहिए, कब फर्स्ट गियर लगाना चाहिए, कब सेकेंड गियर, ये जो चीजें हैं इसको मल्टी टास्किंग बोलते हैं। अगर इनको मैं नहीं जानता हूं तो मैं ड्राइव नहीं कर पाऊंगा, I will not be a good driver. Similarly, अगर मैं कोई चीज algorithm लिख रहा हूँ या कोई computer पे काम कर रहा हूँ तो कैसे print निकाला जाता है या कैसे किसी platform को use किया जाता है या अगर मुझे MATLAB use करना है तो MATLAB को use करना है, वो सारी चीजों की जानकारी करने से अगर आप करेंगे तो you will become self-sufficient. वही multitasking है। अगर जाके किसी जॉब में आप गए नौकरी करने गए वहां पर आपको बोलेगा कि ये सिस्टम खराब है इसको देखिए, आपने कभी प्रैक्टिकल में हाथ नहीं डाला, आपको किसी कंपोनेंट के बारे में पता नहीं है, कंपोनेंट्स के बारे में जानना कि एक रेजिस्टर भी अगर बदलना है तो कैसे बदलना है, ओम्स लॉ को आप रिलेट कीजिए, वहां किरचॉफ लॉ को आप रिलेट कीजिए, पढ़ के निकल गए इम्तिहान पास हो गए कुछ नहीं होगा। तो मल्टी टास्क है जो हर स्टेप्स को एक साथ जोड़ के इंटीग्रेट करता है और उसको अप्लाई करता है। वंस यू अप्लाई थिंग्स, आपने देखा होगा कि मैं सोल्डरिंग भी कर सकता हूँ, मैं ड्राई सोल्डर है या नहीं है वो भी पहचान सकता हूँ, मैं उसको चेक भी कर सकता हूँ, मल्टीमीटर भी यूज कर सकता हूँ, लेवल ऑफ ये वोल्टेज निकाल सकता हूँ, CRO भी यूज कर सकता हूँ, ये मल्टीटास्किंग है। तो अगर आपने अपने पूरे कोर्स में जो जो चीजें आपको बताई वो आपने सीख लिया ठीक से, मतलब ऐसे किया जाता है, बिगिन में कीजिए, बाकी तो आप जब वर्क में जाएंगे, वर्ल्ड ऑफ वर्क में आपको पता चलेगा, लेकिन यहाँ जो आपको फैसिलिटीज है उनको यूज कीजिए, लेबोरेटरी फ्रेंडली होइए, क्वेश्चन पूछिए और हर रोज अपने से क्वेश्चन पूछिए क्या मैंने नया सीखा, तो आप देखेंगे टास्क वन टास्क टू टास्क, ये आप लिखते जाइए अपने डायरी में कि टास्क वन मेरे लिए ये है कि ब्लू प्रिंट रीड करूँ, ये है कि सर्किट को मैं समझूं, टास्क थ्री ये है कि इसको कैसे टेस्ट किया जाए वो सीखूं, टास्क फोर ये है कि कौन से कंपोनेंट्स हैं वो सीखूं, टास्क फाइव ये है कि वो कंपोनेंट्स को किस तरीके से टेस्ट करें, CRO कैसे यूज करें, सप्लाई कैसे लगाए, उसकी क्या स्पेसिफिकेशन है ये सीखूं, ये सारी चीजें जब आप इंटीग्रेट मल्टीपल टास्क मल्टी टास्कर, और वो मल्टी टास्कर को करने के लिए एक स्किल होता है, वो स्किल इसी तरह डेवलप होता है, और इसके लिए आपको एंजाइटी होनी चाहिए, क्वेश्चंस पूछना चाहिए, चुप करके बैठने से नहीं होगा, पार्टिसिपेट करना चाहिए, ये जो आपको डिबेट्स वगैरह होते हैं पार्टिसिपेट कीजिए, कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल बढ़ाइए अपना, यू शुड बी एबल टू टॉक, यू शुड बी एबल टू कम्युनिकेट, यू शुड बी एबल टू क्वेश्चन, देन ओनली आपकी जो क्वेश्चंस है वो क्लियर। इसका मेथड है कि आप चेकलिस्ट बनाइए, चेकलिस्ट बनाइए कि किसी एक पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट को अगर दूसरे सब्जेक्ट से तीसरे टास्क से चौथे टास्क से जोड़ना है वो कौन कौन सी चीजें जिसको मुझे आना चाहिए, उन चेकलिस्ट को क्वेश्चन मार्क लगाइए बाय आस्किंग बाय डिस्कसिंग योर पीयर ग्रुप, योर सीनियर्स, योर टीचर्स, योर पेरेंट्स, किसी से भी आप पूछ सकते हैं, हम जैसे लोगों से भी आप पूछ सकते हैं, हमें आप क्वेश्चन लिख सकते हैं, हमने आपको आपको नंबर भी दिया है, हम फोन कर सकते हैं कि सर ये सर्किट में सॉल्व कर रहा था ये प्रॉब्लम हो गया, अब ये चीजें अगर आप करेंगे तो यू विल बिकम अ मल्टीटास्कर, ये चीज आपको करना चाहिए तभी आप सेलेबल इन द मार्केट होंगे, आपकी मार्केट वैल्यू बढ़ जाएगी, अगर आप नहीं करते हैं तो आपकी मार्केट वैल्यू कभी नहीं बढ़ेगी, प्लीज डोंट बी अ बुकिश, ट्राई टू बी ए लेबोरेटरी फ्रेंडली पर्सन, ट्राई टू बी सॉर्ट ऑफ पर्सन हु डिस्कसेस थिंग्स, हु क्वेश्चंस, हु वांट्स टू नो न्यू थिंग, लिखिए डायरी के अंदर और टिक करते जाइए कि मैंने ये टास्क सीख लिया है, अब मुझे ये सीखना है, और हर रोज अपने आप को क्वेश्चन कीजिए कि मुझे नया क्या टास्क सीखना है, दैट इज द वे ऑफ बिकमिंग अ मल्टीटास्कर।
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू।
आर देयर एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस?
हेलो
हेलो
हेलो सर,
एक्चुअली आई वांट टू नो in present scenario there yes. are many who have the many managers to fulfill their requirements to step hum ye dekhe ki ek leader uske under kai manager hain aur wo bhi easily leader task kar le raha hai but leader ki jo practical quality hai wo quality wo handle nahi kar raha hai to sir ye agar hum leadership ki characteristic dekhe to us hisab se ye kahan tak jo hai safal mana jayega leader
आपका आप योर गुड नेम प्लीज प्रकाश चंद्रा, प्रकाश चंद्रा जी बोल रहे हैं, प्रकाश चंद्र वर्मा, ओके वर्मा जी, ऐसा है कि जो क्वेश्चन आप कर रहे हैं वो एक ऐसा क्वेश्चन है कि वो लीडर के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है कि हाउ केपेबल ही इज, अब यहाँ पर कौन से लीडर की बात, मैनेजर और अ मैनेजर वर्क्स मैनेजर और द सीईओ समथिंग लाइक, अगर इनकी बात आप कर रहे हैं तो वो आदमी उस लेवल में तभी पहुंचेगा जब वो इन सब चीजों से वाकिफ होगा, इन सब चीजों को अच्छी तरह जानेगा, मैंने बोला कि किसी चीज को सुपरवाइज वो तभी कर सकता है व्हेन ही बिकम्स अ मास्टर इन दैट जॉब, उसको हर चीज को अच्छी तरह जानना पड़ेगा, अदरवाइज ही डज नॉट डिजर्व टू बी दैट पर्टिकुलर सीईओ और मैनेजर और जीएम और व्हाटएवर इट इज, वो तो हमेशा ये टरकाने वाली बात करेगा कि यू हैव कम विद अ प्रॉब्लम एंड डोंट कम विद अ प्रॉब्लम, कम विद अ सॉल्यूशन सो दैट आई कैन टेल यू नो यस दिस सॉल्यूशन इज गुड, तो वो चीज नहीं है, ज्यादातर लोग ऐसे ही होते हैं, लेकिन ये जो प्रॉब्लम है वो सॉल्व नहीं कर पाते हैं, इक्का दुक्का ऐसे लोग होते हैं जिनके पास हर चीज का सलूशन होता है, एंड दैट इज द लीडर वी आर लुकिंग फॉर। वो चीज है, वो तभी होगा जब वो शुरू से खुद मास्टर बनेगा। सुपरवाइजर वो होता है जो उस पूरे जॉब को अच्छी तरह जानता है, तभी वो क्वेश्चन बता सकता है, तभी वो खामियां बता सकता है, बॉटलनेक्स ढूंढ सकता है या गाइड कर सकता है। अगर मान लीजिए कि पीएचडी थीसिस गाइड कर रहे हैं और जो गाइड कर रहे हैं उसको खुद ही उस सब्जेक्ट के बारे में नहीं पता है, तो हाउएवर गुड ही मे बी, जैसे नाम की डिग्री है, वो गाइड नहीं कर पाएंगे। वो बेचारा जो उसके पास जाता है वो फ्रस्ट्रेट होकर लौटेगा और उसके पास एक ही सोल्यूशन होगा, या तो वे दूसरों से डिस्कस करे थिंग्स, या वो जो अवेलेबल है उनको पकड़े, या पीयर ग्रुप के पास जाए और फाइनली वो अपनी क्वेश्चंस को सॉल्व करे। सो इसलिए अब ये जो दूसरा जो पीएचडी कर रहा है वो इससे ट्रेंड हो जाएगा। He will come to know things because aapko solutions thunna, you have to acquire the solutions. But I am not talking of that kind of a leader. I am not talking of that kind of a manager who doesn't have solutions. Wo tarkane wali baat wo nahi mat kar. Is it okay, please?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I hope all the questions are done.
Yes.
I would like to invite Honorable Director BBD ITM Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan to bless us with his words.
Thank you, Ms. Shambhavi, anchor of the program. First of all, on behalf of our chairperson, Srimati Alka Das, and President of BBD Education Group, Sri Viraj Sagar Das, and on behalf of whole IEEE as well as Electrical Electronics branch of engineering, I offer a deep sense of gratitude towards Professor S. Chatterjee, who is, agar main kahun seedhe shabdon mein to, bheeshm pitamah hai electrical engineering ke, kyunki yahan jitne bhi bacche maujood hain, mujhe saubhagya abhi beech mein pichle do interaction mein nahi mil paya, jiske liye main kshama mangta hu sir se, lekin main itna sabhi ko jankari main dalna chahunga jo is patal pe is samay shikshak va chhatraen maujood hain, ki जैसे मैटलैब की अगर बात करें तो मैटलैब वैसे तो 85 ऑनवर्ड्स डिफरेंट यूनिवर्सिटी में वेस्ट में आ चुका था, लेकिन इंडिया में उसने 2000 में टेक ऑफ लिया, और जो टेक ऑफ ले रहा था या बल्क बाकी भी इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग के जितने भी रीसेंट डेवलपमेंट्स हैं नॉर्थ इंडिया में, तो वो सारे टेक ऑफ जब ही करते थे जब प्रोफेसर चटर्जी उसको पूर्वानुमान लगा के उसके महत्व को समझ के उससे जुड़ के चीज़ों को आगे बढ़ाते थे। तो मुझे भी सौभाग्य मिला सन 2001-02 में कि मैंने मैटलैब के कोर्सेज वहाँ पे किए और प्रोफेसर चटर्जी वाज हैंडलिंग एट दैट अफेयर्स। तो मुझे एज ए मतलब नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ जो टेक्निकल टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग एंड रिसर्च चंडीगढ़ है, तो वहाँ पर जाने का सौभाग्य मिला। और ये माना जाता था कि इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग में अगर आप नॉर्थ इंडिया में ही नहीं पूरे भारतवर्ष में कहीं रिलेटेड हैं तो आप अगर प्रोफेसर चटर्जी को नहीं जानते हैं तो इसका मतलब आप इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग में अभी आपने कुछ किया नहीं है। और ये मैं सर को खुश करने की नियत से नहीं कह रहा, बहुत ईमानदारी और जिम्मेदारी से कह रहा हूँ। तो जब मैंने मैटलैब का वो ट्रेनिंग कोर्स किया था जिसका मैं आज भी ट्रेजर करता हूँ उस मेमोरी को, क्योंकि वो मेरी पहली मुलाकात थी मैटलैब से और बाद में वो मेरे लिए बहुत अहम बनी, मेरी रिसर्च में भी उसने एक फंडामेंटल रोल प्ले किया। तो उस दौर में सन 2000 के शुरुआती दौर की बात बता रहा हूँ मैं, सन 1 और 2 में, सर को याद भी होगा जब उन्होंने कराया था, मेरा मेरे बारे में शायद याद हो ना हो क्योंकि वहाँ तो टेक्निकल टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग में हजारों टीचर्स जाके अपने कोर्सेज करके आते हैं और डिफरेंट डिसिप्लिन से भी आते हैं। तो जिस गर्म जोशी से सर सेशन को बिगिन करते थे और फिर बाद में और एसोसिएट टीचर्स उसको हैंडल करते थे, वो गर्म जोशी मैं आज भी देख रहा हूँ। और बच्चों ने महसूस किया होगा कि सर के जो विचारों में सफाई और सच्चाई जो है वो सीधे सीधे दिखाई देती है और आपके कम्प्लेक्स से कम्प्लेक्स चीज जो है वो सिंप्लीफाई हो जाती है, जिस वजह से आज हम देख भी रहे थे लगातार सवालों की बारिश आ रही थी और गंभीर मुद्दे थे। अगर कोई सुने उसको एज ए लिसनर तो वो बहुत मामूली दिखाई देते हैं, लेकिन जो उससे जूझ रहा है उसके लिए वो सबसे बड़े मुद्दे होते हैं। तो सर जिस दक्षता से उसको उसका समाधान बताते हैं, जिस सरलीकरण से उसको प्रस्तुत करते हैं, वो रियली प्रभावशाली और हम सब के लिए प्रेरणा है। और मैं पूरी IEEE चैप्टर को बधाई देना चाहता हूं कि सर के साथ एक उन्होंने संबंध स्थापित कर लिया है। ये मेरे लिए भी एज ए निदेशक बहुत ही खुशी का विषय है और सर अपना आशीर्वाद लगातार मुझे मालूम है सभी इंस्टीट्यूट से जो कि सर से जुड़ने की कोशिश करते हैं, कभी भी उन्हें निराश नहीं करते और उन्होंने कर्तव्य को मुझे लगता है कि सर्वोच्च वरीयता दी है, एक शिक्षक को जो देनी चाहिए। उन्होंने कभी भी, शायद मुझे सर की जो पुरानी यादें हैं कि सर ने कभी भी नौकरी की तरह नौकरी नहीं की, जो मैं बार बार कहता भी हूँ, सर ने उसको बहुत जिम्मेदारी से किया है और सही मायने में आई थिंक ही इज अ ट्रू लीडर और ही इंस्पायर्स जनरेशंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियर। और जैसा मैंने कहा तो मैं ये मानता हूँ कि यहाँ सारे बच्चे जो मौजूद हैं, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम मिस संभावी एंड यू नो द मे बी चेयरपर्सन मिस्टर श्रीकांत एंड ऑल अदर डियर स्टूडेंट्स, कि आपके लिए सौभाग्य की बात है कि आप नई पीढ़ी में हैं, फिर भी प्रोफेसर चटर्जी से सर का आशीर्वाद आपको मिल रहा है और आप जुड़ पा रहे हैं। क्योंकि जो पुरानी पीढ़ी है, क्योंकि मैं अब तो अपने आप को युवा भी मानता हूँ, साथ के साथ एक ऐसी भी पीढ़ी मानता हूँ जिसने कि पिछले लगभग 2-2.5 दशक से इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग से जुड़ा रहा हूँ और सेवा करने का सौभाग्य मिला है। तो हमारे दौर में जब हम शुरुआत करते थे तो हम मानते थे कि प्रोफेसर चटर्जी सर को सुन लिया या उनको देख लिया तो यू अंडरस्टैंड कि यू हैव अराइव्ड, आप पहुंच गए हैं, जगह पे पहुंच गए हैं और आपको अब जमीन मिलनी शुरू हो गई। तो सर बहुत बहुत आभार और मैं क्या कहूँ, आपको नमन करता हूँ, सादर नमन करता हूँ और आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ पूरे एजुकेशनल ग्रुप की तरफ से कि अब आपका आशीर्वाद लगातार मिल रहा है और पूरे बीबीडी के जो IEEE चैप्टर है उसमें प्रोफेसर रफीक अहमद एंड डॉक्टर खादिम मोइन सिद्दीकी के माध्यम से उनको बहुत बहुत बधाई देता हूँ कि उन्होंने इस प्रोग्राम को किया और आपसे पास्ट में भी जुड़े रहे और आगे भी आपका आशीर्वाद मिलता रहेगा। बहुत अच्छा ये चैप्टर कर रहा है सर, मुझे लगता है आपके से शुरू में ही हम लोगों को आशीर्वाद मिल गया था तो उसके ये शुभ लक्षण और शुभ फल हमको मिल रहे हैं। और संभावी, और मुझे एक और बात कहना चाहूंगा जो मैं निरंतर महसूस करता हूँ कि हमारा पूरा बैच जो इलेक्ट्रिकल का भले ही संख्या बल में बहुत बड़ा ना हो लेकिन बहुत ही गुणवान है और बहुत ही जागरूक है और ये जो नई पीढ़ी आ रही है सेकंड ईयर की, आई एम रियली बाउल्ड ओवर बाई देयर टैलेंट एंड जील एंड डिटर्मिनेशन टू रियली डू वेल। सो आई अप्रिशिएट होल IEEE चैप्टर, ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ IEEE टू रियली कंडक्ट दिस प्रोग्राम। एंड सर बहुत बहुत नमन और बहुत बहुत मेरे पास शब्द नहीं है क्योंकि एक जब एक ऐसा छात्र है जो अपने गुरु से जो बहुत पुराने हैं, जैसे मैंने कहा भीष्म पितामह, मुझे लगता है सर इसको एक पॉजिटिव सेंस में ही लेंगे क्योंकि सर ने जिस तरीके के अपना कार्य शैली और यू नो कार्य क्षमता को लगातार बनाए रखा है, ईश्वर उन पर ऐसी कृपा बना के रखे और हम सब लाभान्वित होते रहें। एक बार पुनः हम सभी की ओर से नमन और धन्यवाद सर।
धन्यवाद, थैंक यू सो मच, इतने अच्छे शब्द आपने मेरे लिए बोले, पता नहीं मैं जब भी करता हूं कहीं, थैंक यू सो मच, बहुत सुंदर लगा आपका लिख, थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर योर प्रेशियस वर्ड्स।
थैंक यू मिस
Now, I would like to invite Organizing Secretary Dr. Khadim Moin Siddiqui to propose vote of thanks. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Shambhavi. Shambhavi, I am audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, very good. A very good afternoon, Honorable, Eminent and Esteemed Speaker Dr. S. Chatterjee, Professor Retired and IEEE Chandigarh, Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan, Honorable Director, BBTITM Lucknow, respected HOD, ENDN Professor Rafiq Ahmed, faculty participants, student participants, and volunteers. It's my proud privilege to propose vote of thanks in the expert lecture, My Story Motivational Session by Successful Innovators. Today, for expert lecture, we can say have an eminent ideal academicians, professionals, educators, leaders and many more. Yes, we have Honorable Speaker Dr. S. Chatterjee. Today we have observed large number of students, faculties and volunteers have joined to listen and learn from our eminent speakers. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, Honorable Sir, for giving us your valuable time with efficient life-changing ideas and also for motivating us to become a valuable person for humanitarian. Indeed, your lecture has benefited us a lot and always gives us inspiration, positive energy to work with great zeal and enthusiasm. Honorable Sir, thank you so much for accepting our invitation gladly and always ready to nurture young generation to participate in the development of the nation and country. Further, I would like to thank to Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan, Honorable Director, BBD ITM Lucknow, for constructive and concrete guidance. Honorable Sir, thank you so much again. Further, I would like to thank to our respected HOD, Professor Rafiq Ahmed, for his support. Sir, due to your support and efforts, we are able to organize this kind of program in the effective way. Now, thanks to DI Professor Shivanand, all faculty participants, student participants, for joining us and making this event successful. At last but not least, thanks IEEE BBD ITM student branch, especially Mr. Srikant Singh, Mr. Maruthandan Tripathi, Ms. Shivali Prasad, Mr. Avinash Gupta, Ms. Anshika Rai, Mr. Shrek Khanna, Mr. Abdullah Ahmed, Ms. Shreya Rai, Ms. Shambhavi, and all IEEE student members for your diligence to conduct this program in the effective way. Again, thank you so much all.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू सो मच सर. नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट आवर ऑनरेबल डायरेक्टर प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर भावेश कुमार चौहान टू डिक्लेयर द इवेंट क्लोज. सर प्लीज.
विद द काइंड परमिशन ऑफ आवर स्पीकर ऑफ द डे प्रोफेसर एस चटर्जी, वी वुड लाइक टू कंक्लूड द प्रोग्राम सर.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you so much, sir. We have been gracious for your eminent presence over here today. At last, I would like to request the participants. Feedback form has been circulated in the chat section. Kindly fill it. Now I request everyone to leave the meeting. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.